I'm not coming for the lost sheep of the Gentiles?
No, he didn't. He said, I only came.
They are filming. So this is not. No, they're filming. Come on.
That's no problem.
I have to go.
Don't record, إخوان. Let's give a da'wah, inshallah.
That's my daughter.
Huh? Say again?
That's my daughter, Binti, watching.
Alhamdulillah. Would that say Christian as well? Are you Christian?
I'm Christian. I'm Arab Christian.
You Arab Christian?
Yes, Syrian Christian.
كيف تقرأ القرآن بالعربية؟
رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم.
الرحمن الرحيم. You know what I was going to ask you? Yeah, what I was going to ask you, how can you read the beauty of the Quran, the Arabic language? And please, can you tell me through the history, through the human history, is there anyone speaks like Noon? والقلم وما يسطرون ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون أو كاف ها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا أور الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان أو الحمد جميل. لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا هذا كلام لم يعرف في التاريخ
من كتبه؟
هذا من عند الله سبحانه وتعالى Yeah, because that's my challenge. My challenge, bring me someone in history speaks like this. No one, no one, even the Arab pagans, they never speak like that. And you know what is very interesting? When you look at the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you look at his Sunnah, the way he speaks is completely different than the Quranic style. That is a proof the Quran is not from the Prophet Muhammad. Because it's impossible for someone to move from so perfect, so eloquent, beautiful style of speaking to way lower. You understand? Are you going to pull him as well?
Yes.
I want you the Rajul Bada. The Rajul pull, not the moment pull.
Nice to see you. I watch you on YouTube.
Barakallahu fik.
I watch you because I want to... I was born a Muslim.
MashaAllah.
You're not gonna like this.
No, you can say anything. I mean, I'm here to respond to it, inshallah.
I have, you know, growing questions. But I watch your videos.
Yeah, you can ask, inshallah.
To persuade myself, yeah. To bring back that
iman, that belief, that certainty.
But
yeah.
It's just hard, brother. Like, there are a lot of like questions to ask.
Okay, what you have to do? What's your name, firstly, brother? What's your
Burak,
name?
Burak.
Huh?
Burak.
Murad.
Burak. Burak. B-U-R-A-K.
Burak. Okay. Okay, you Turkish?
Turkish.
Yeah, clock 20, see?
Yeah, yeah.
MashaAllah, nice to meet you, my brother. Look, Akhi, you have a difference between asking questions and between whisper of a shaitan. Because remember, shaitan isn't going to leave you or leave me alone. You understand? So if you have questions, we are here to answer it according to our knowledge, according to our abilities, yes? But also, there are certain questions should not be asked. Not because there's no answer for it, because the question itself is sophistry. You know what is sophistry? For example, let me give you an example.
You made God. I know that's stupid.
That is stupid. Yeah, or if God's able to do it, like the Christian argument, if God's able to do everything, can he become a man? That's sophistry. Do you know why?
I don't have questions.
No, I'm not saying like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if God become a man is limited.
Yeah, yeah.
But God has a unlimited power. Yeah, yeah. So that's a paradox. Doesn't make any sense. But if you have any questions, then also there's a question that some Muslims have. It's based upon liberalism or secularism or atheism. Foundation, mm-hmm. Understand? Mm-hmm. So yeah, so he's been heavily influenced by liberalism, or atheism, or secularism, and he thinks Islam opposes sound reasoning. But Islam doesn't oppose sound reasoning. Islam opposes the opinion that he's been influenced by. Mm-hmm. You understand my point?
Yeah.
So if we agree with that, so what is the questions you have? Like for example.
For example, I know you probably heard it a million times.
So this time it's gonna be 1 million and 1.
Because no one's giving me the proper answer, do you know what I mean? My question is, if God is all-knowing, omnipotent, and he knows everything that's gonna happen, that's
yeah.
happened, everything.
Yeah.
And we have free will.
Yeah.
Why is people like Hitler and Stalin born into this world? And the response I get with that,
yeah.
I'm trying to say is, everybody's got their own choice and their own decisions, and Hitler and Stalin decided with their own free will that Allah gave them,
yeah.
they decided to do that. But my counter to that would be, didn't Allah know what decisions he was going to make before he even thought about making it?
Yeah, we don't say thought, because thought when you don't know. Firstly, see, that's one of the questions that is a sophistry question.
You don't? You think it's not?
It's not. Do you know why? Because you want to dictate to Allah what he should do. Yes, I'll give you an example of that. Is it logical and rational for someone who has a little knowledge to judge someone who has a perfect knowledge?
Of course not. That's okay. Why, that's why I'm not fully...
That's my point. No, my point here. See, when I mentioned about sovereignty questions, sometimes you think it's illogical, but it's not in reality. Okay. Example of that, because now Allah only told us, because the question be valid, why Allah create Hitler in paradise? If Hitler's going to kill people in paradise. Because paradise is not a place for a test. Okay? That would be a logical argument. Why Hitler is in paradise killing people when paradise should be no killing, no nothing. But in this life, Allah only tells us to test us through our life, through our wealth, through our children. So it makes sense. You understand? So you see, your question is based upon the wrong premises. Because your premises, you think in this life should be perfect. But that's not the life that Allah told us to be perfect. The life that should be perfect is paradise. When I say perfect, mean there's no killing, there's no this, understand? So that's my point. My point is, many Muslims, when they ask questions, and that's how I said, ask, no problem. Sometimes we have a doubt because, so why doubt called doubt?
It defies logic, you're basically saying. Some principles defies.
It's sound reasoning. You understand? Because, for example, I'll say to you, for example, and now, if a daughter, she said to her father, oh, forget that, the story in the Quran of Musa and Khadr, do you know about it?
Musa, yeah, I know Musa.
Al-Khadr is in Surah Al-Kahf. This story, Yahi, explains everything for us. Every doubt about Allah's Qadr, about evil, explains it. Let us see how, okay? So, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, once was asked by his followers, Israelites, من أعلم الناس, as we mentioned Bukhari. Oh Musa, who is the most knowledgeable person? According to Musa, he's a prophet of Allah, therefore he's the most knowledgeable person. He said, I. So he said to him, then, what they call it? He said to him, Allah told him, rebuked him. When I say rebuked him, by the way, it's not like, it corrected him, all right? He said, don't say that. You should say the knowledge of this particular question is with Allah. Allah said to Musa, I'm going to send you to someone who has more knowledge than you. Okay, Al-Khadr, he has a knowledge of what? The ulama mentioned, or I will let you know after. So now Musa met Al-Khadr. Al-Khadr said to Musa, alayhi salam, don't travel with me because you're going to see certain things is going to disturb you. And I'm sure you're not going to be able to withhold yourself. Musa said, I will. So they're walking together. They had to cross a river. They were young boys, poor. They had this boat, they were utilizing it to work, to make money from it, to help people to cross from one side to the other side. They knew Khidr, he was a righteous man, so they allowed him to board for free, okay, to jump on the boat for free. Yeah. When they dropped them off, Al-Khidr scratched the boat. Wow. Musa said, Musa said, what are you doing? These young boys, they just helped us, you scratched their boat. You and I, and all of us here, if we saw Khidr doing that, we will call Al-Khadr, what is it? Evil man. Look, people did favor to you, took care of you, and he scratched their boat. Khadr said to him, I told you, you're not gonna be patient with me. He said, carry on. He said, I'm not gonna ask, carry on. Second time they're walking, they saw a young boy. Al-Khadr went and killed him. He said, how dare you? You're killing a young boy. He commit no sin. Why are you killing him? That way, step back. See? Now, if all of us standing here, and we'll see Al-Khadr's action, all of us, we're going to misjudge Al-Khadr's action. Why? Because Al-Khadr, Allah gave him ilmul ilal. What is ilmul ilal? The knowledge of the outcome. We know the knowledge of, because there's two types of knowledge. There's a hidden knowledge, and there's a knowledge which is dahir, manifested knowledge. Allah possesses both of them. All right? So, Al-Khadr, Allah gave him some of the hidden knowledge of certain actions, what will lead to. Yes? So now, the third time, they're walking together, they went to a village, they asked the people, welcome us, host us. They say, no, we're not gonna host you. So there was a wall, it's about to collapse. Al-Khadr go to fix it. Musa said, your story is very strange. You're a very strange person. Those who helped us, you scratch their boat. Those who reject to help us, you go help them. He said, today's enough. He said, as for the first one, the boys, they had king in their village, and they used to take away any boat that is in a good condition. So I scratch it in order for the people to not take it away from them. So is it evil or good now?
In hindsight, good.
It's good now.
Yeah.
Because what? It saved him from the evil leader. Because the king, if he left the boat the way it is, the king was going to take it away from them.
Yeah.
And there will be what? No money for them. So that scratch from us, it looks like an evil thing, but in the reality, that was good. You see?
Can you apply that with everything?
Of course, when it comes to Allah's action, then which one is more rational, more logical? If Musa misjudged the action of Al-Khadr, who is another human being like him, what about the action of Allah, which behind the perfect knowledge, perfect wisdom?
So you're basically saying we can't comprehend anything.
No, certain things we can't comprehend because there's a hidden knowledge behind it. Yes, there's a hidden reasons. Also, that's what Ibn al-Qayyim, one of the Muslim scholars, Ibn Taymiyyah said. He said, Islam never came to oppose sound reasoning, but it came to blow away the sound reasoning. For example, like me, I don't know how the traffic light works. If you explain it to me, I think, oh my God, you understand, it's unbelievable. But doesn't mean because I don't know how it works, therefore it's some nonsense. You understand, akhi? So that's my point. You have to have a foundation. When you have this foundation, you can deal with every doubt, inshallah ta'ala. So when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's irrational or logical, impossible for me or you to judge Allah's action. Because, for example, I met someone, I said to him, why don't you believe in Allah? He said, how can I believe in Allah? When I was young, my mother passed away. So therefore, according to this person, Allah should not take his mother away. Otherwise, it's not Allah. Okay, I met another person, a girl. So she said to me, I'm not going to believe in Allah because when I was young, I was sexually abused. So according to her, Allah does not exist because... So now what they want God according to their ways. It's like, take away. I want God, but he can only do this. That's illogical because God is the master, is the Rabb, is the sovereign, has a sovereign. You understand, brother?
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah.
I think a lot of people have that.
You're welcome, auntie.
My country, especially here,
from your country? What country from?